The beauty of these experiments is that literally no one equals any other.
Nestlé has a very particular way of building brands, and the way we start is what we call knowing our consumer deeply.
Today, as Maria mentioned, we started with the target audience portrait that we have, which are the status seekers. And the traditional way of doing these things is that we used to create campaigns based on a general idea of what they like and what they aspire to and what their behavior is online.
When Maria came and she wanted basically to sell me the idea at the beginning, I said, okay, can you explain to me more in detail, what are we trying to achieve, what are we trying to do?
And I think then one day I came in and I'm like, no, we need to do more with this idea. And
Google wants to experiment
and all of these things. And this is where we touched base with the Google team. We told them we have a great idea. And from their end, they came to us and they're like, we have an experiment that we want to try with you guys.
Nescafe Dolce Gusto is a fun brand, so we knew from the very beginning that our execution needs to bring this fun to life. So we thought of the domino effect. We created this team, but we always start with Nescafe Dolce Gusto machine, which is always the beginning of the day, it's the beginning of our story.
So the way the experiment was created, we had one configuration, which was the base that consisted of a longer form, a true view, and a bumper as a remarketing asset. Then we had the a stream of content, the fashionista stream of content, again the true view and its bumper, and then the travel content that was tailored to the travel enthusiasts that again had the true view and a bumper.
What really caught us all off guard was the depth of the learnings. We were expecting, and we know it, personalization works. But in this particular case, we also debunked a mythology, which is that when you skip an ad, you are not impacted, and anyway, you are not bothered. And we saw that personalization works wonders even with skippers.
The main thing that we set out to experiment or set out to prove is, can we really break the clutter by becoming closer in our communication to that target audience?
If I can build on what Naji has said, for us it was also important. It was a first step to what we call personalized consumer experience, to customize content really to different needs of our target consumers. And as such, it was also a very good learning to move in this direction.
The second really important insight that we got out of this experiment is that different audiences react in a different way to the same message. So in our case, travelers and travel enthusiasts who are used to a research mindset, the first thing they did once they were exposed to the ad was research. So they went to Google, they went to YouTube, and they searched for the brand, they searched for the product, in a very intense way. On the other hand, fashionistas that were more impacted by the ad itself and the message itself, so they did not exhibit this research mindset, but they saw that they remembered the ad and the brand at a much higher level.
I'm really excited about the positive results that we got, and hope we'll have more and more such experiments in the future. I like to experiment and on the digital front, so this is something really exciting for us.
This is the future for us, for NDG, and I think this is the way forward. There's no way we can go back to one content fits all or non-personalized content anymore. This is our future.